Hello friends, welcome once again in my home class. So we are in chapter 8 of grade 11 of NEB, and till yesterday we had discussed some theorems of said chapter, and today we are going to prove some other theorems given in the chapter of said. Okay, so today we are going to introduce first of all De Morgan's law. Okay, so hope you are also familiar with this law. So, De Morgan's law states that for any two sets A and B, if A and B are the subsets of any universal set U, then first property, A union B of complement will be equal to A complement intersection B complement, and A intersection B complement will be equal to A complement union B complement. Means, what we have to understand that if here it will be union, then it will be intersection. And if it will be intersection, then here it will be union. So let us prove it is one of the important question that has appeared in your NEB board exam also. So please take care of this question for 4 marks. State and prove De Morgan's law. So let's come to the proof of first one. Proof. Left hand side. Okay, so left hand side, it is given to us A union B of complement. A union B of complement. So this will be equal to, let us assume one element in this set. So it is X, let X be the element of this set. So X such that X belongs to A union B of complement. Okay. Now let's go ahead. This will be equal to X such that X belongs to A union B of complement, means X does not belong to A union B. Okay, its meaning is this: X belongs to A union B complement, it means X does not belong to A union B. Okay, now then this will be equal to X such that, now let's multiply this, let's open this bracket, it will be X does not belong to A, and remember one thing, if here is does not belong to, then while opening, in place of union we used to write or previously, but now we don't write or. If it does not belong to, it is union, then while opening the bracket we write just opposite of or, that is and. Okay, so and X does not belong to B. Bhanese aba yesma euta kura ke bujhnus bhanda kheri, yadi yaha does not belong to cha bhane, yadi suppose belong to matrai bhako bhaye, belong to bhako bhaye ke hunthyo, X belongs to A or X belongs to B, or out here, tara yaha ke cha, does not belong to, sir. Does not belong to bhako le ke huncha, or na aera or ko sath hamle ke lekhna parcha, hamle end lekhna parcha. Okay, we have to write here end. Now this will be equal to X such that X does not belong to A and X does not belong to B. So X does not belong to A means X belongs to A complement and X belongs to B complement. So this will be X such that X belongs to A complement and X belongs to B complement means X belongs to A complement intersection B complement, and means intersection. So this will be equal to A complement intersection B complement. This is equal to right hand side proved. Okay, so it is about the first proof. Now let us go to the second proof. Okay, hope you got the point. Now let's go to the second proof, second number. So I will just make some edit over here. In place of union there is intersection. Okay, so here also it will be intersection, same. So again it will be X does not belong to A intersection B. So if here is intersection does not belong to, here it would be end, but since it is does not belong to, so we have to write or. Okay, so it means it will be or. X such that X belongs to A bar or X belongs to B bar. So or means it will be union and also it will be union. So this is equal to right hand side. Okay, just by changing the symbols and the sign we can get the second proof very easily. Okay, so hope you are getting the point. Now let's go to four number proof. Fourth first. first of four number, left hand side, we have A minus B intersection C. So this will be equal to X such that X belongs to A minus B intersection C. Okay, we have to estimate, we have to let one, suppose one element belong to this set. So let us go in further operation. This will be equal to X such that X belongs to A and X does not belong to B intersection C. Okay, so yasma euta kura ke bujhnus bhanda, for example, suppose X belongs to A minus B cha bhane hamle open garda ke huncha bhanda, X belongs to A and X does not belong to B. We have to use this statement. Okay, similarly here also A minus B intersection C. So X belongs to A and X does not belong to B intersection C. So let's go ahead now. We will get, this will be equal to X such that X belongs to A, and let us open this again as previous. We will get X does not belong to B. There is intersection, so we have to use or, because there is does not belong to, or X does not belong to C. Okay, then this will be equal to X such that, let us multiply this, we will get X belongs to A and X does not belong to B, or this or will be here again, from here to here it will be X belongs to A and X does not belong to C. Okay, so this will be equal to X such that X belongs to A and X does not belong to B. It means X belongs to A minus B, or X belongs to A and X does not belong to C. It means X belongs to A minus C. Okay, so now A minus B union A minus C, clearly you can see over here, this will be equal to X such that X belongs to A minus B union A minus C. A minus C. Okay, so one more bracket, then this will be equal to A minus B union A minus C. This is equal to right hand side. Okay, it is also proved. Now two number is also quite similar, and three number is also quite similar, but I would like to do the third one. Second question, you can do it as homework. It is quite easy. Just in place of intersection there is union, so you also go on changing the symbols only, easily you can prove it. Okay, so be careful my dear friends, such question have appeared for 4 marks in your NEB board exam. Okay, now let's go to third proof. So third question is this one. Let us take its left hand side, A intersection B minus C. So this will be equal to X such that X belongs to A intersection B minus C. Okay, we have approximated, we have assumed one element in this set. So this will be equal to X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B minus C. Okay, so X belongs to A and X belongs to B minus C. Now go ahead, this will be equal to X such that X belongs to A and, open this in bracket, what you will get, X belongs to B and X does not belong to C. X does not belong to C. Now this will be equal to X such that, let us open the bracket, it will be X belongs to A and X belongs to B. Okay, and X belongs to A and X does not belong to C. Okay. Now, from here, what we get is x such that from these two points we will get x belongs to A and x belongs to B means x such that x belongs to A intersection B. From here, we got this one. And now please focus in this point. What do you understand from here? X belongs to A and x does not belong to C. It means if we write x does not belong to A intersection C, do you agree in this point? See, x belongs to A and x does not belong to C. Means suppose we have got two sets A and C. So x belongs to A and x does not belong to C. Means obviously x does not belong to intersection also. Okay? भने कुनै एलिमेन्ट चाहिँ तपाईको ए मा पर्ने सी मा नपर्ने पर्दै नपर्ने भन्नु पर्छ यहाँ पनि नपर्ने हो मिन्स x does not belong to A intersection C. So this point and this point, these statements are equivalent. Okay, so from here we can go ahead. Now this will be equal to x such that x belongs to A intersection B minus x belongs to A intersection B minus A intersection C. Okay, so it will be equal to A intersection B minus A intersection C. This is equal to right hand side. It is also proved. Okay, so all these are the important properties which you can get in your book as well as in your old is gold. These questions have come for the long question. Okay, so here we have finished our all the proofs now. Okay, one more proof is there about the symmetric difference. Let us prove that statement also. Okay, so here we have got one question. We have to prove that A delta B is equal to A union B minus A intersection B. So let us go to its proof. From definition, we have read the definition of symmetric difference, that is, from definition, what we know that A delta B is equal to, we know A delta B is equal to A minus B union B minus A. This we have read the definition of symmetric difference. Okay, please see the session of my definition of the said chapter. So this will be equal to x belongs to A minus B union B minus A. Okay, we have estimated one element in this set. This set means this set. So this will be equal to x such that x belongs to A minus B, or union means, or x belongs to B minus A. Okay, so hope you are getting the point. Now let's open this. This will be equal to x such that x belongs to A and x does not belong to B. From this statement, x belongs to A and x does not belong to B, or let us open this also. We will get x belongs to B and x does not belong to A. Okay, so here x belongs to A and x does not belong to B, or x belongs to B and x does not belong to A. Let us put this in bracket. Now let us arrange all this, and what we get that x such that x belongs to A, or x belongs to B, x belongs to A, or x belongs to B. Let us, x belongs to A or x belongs to B. Let us put it in one place. Okay, x belongs to A or x belongs to B. And what we get is next one, x belongs to A and x belongs to B. And what, x does not belong to, x does not belong to, or x does not belong to B. Okay, x belongs to A or x belongs to B, and x does not belong to A or x does not belong to B. So from here, now what we get is, this will be equal to x such that x belongs to A union B. X belongs to A union B. And next what we get is, x belongs to A or x does not belong to A or x does not belong to B. It means x does not belong to A intersection B. Okay, x does not belong to A intersection B. It means this portion. If you open this, what you will get? You will get the same one. X does not belong to A. In place of intersection, we have to write or x does not belong to B. So from here, now overall what we get is x such that x belongs to A union B minus A intersection B. Okay, let's put this in a bracket. So this will be equal to A union B minus A intersection B. This is equal to A union B minus A intersection B. This is equal to right hand side. Okay, so hope you have got the clear cut knowledge now of this all theories, whatever we have learned in this chapter. Now after this, let's do few questions from exercise as well. And most of the questions which are given in exercise, they are all similar to all these types of theories which we have learned up to now in this said chapter, but also some special questions which had appeared in our board exam also. Let us see few 3-4 questions of short type. Long questions are of these types. Okay, so let's go to some few short questions. Okay, now here I have brought you few questions from your book exercise. So first question is, we have to prove A intersection B is subset of B. So let us do this question. Solution, it is quite easy. Let us take its left hand side and let us take one element in the left hand side. So let x belongs to A intersection B. X belongs to A intersection B. So this implies, yale ke bhancha bhanda, x belongs to A and x belongs to B. X belongs to A and x belongs to B. So this will imply that x belongs to B. Obviously, x belongs to A and x belongs to B means x belongs to B. So from here, we can say that A intersection B is subset of B. So therefore, A intersection B is subset of B. It is proved. Okay. Now, let's go to the B number. Also of same type. Okay. So B number solution. We have to prove A minus B is subset of A. So let x belongs to A minus B. Okay, x belongs to A minus B. So this will imply that x belongs to A and x does not belong to B. X belongs to A and x does not belong to B. So this will imply that x belongs to A. Okay. So from here again we can get, so this will imply that A minus B is subset of A. Okay. So hope you are feeling easy now. Let's come to C number of same type. Okay. So C number proof. Let x belongs to A minus B. Okay. So this will imply that x belongs to A and x does not belong to B. So this will imply that x belongs to A. Yes, obviously. So this will imply that if x belongs to A, then x belongs to A union B also. Isn't it? So now from this and this we can say that therefore A minus B is subset of A union B. It's quite easy. Okay. So it is about one number. Let's do some more questions. Okay, so here is one next question. It is a two number question. So actually we have to create a general idea of solving such type of question. Okay, so every question, whatever you are dealing with, you just follow whatever the instructions I have given to you. With those all instructions, you can solve any type of questions. Sometimes we have to use our own logic as well. Okay, so please be creative, be logical. Okay, so let's go to A number proof. So if you are getting this subset type of question, so how we are proving, please note down. Okay, so let x belongs to A. So x belongs to A. This implies that x belongs to A means x does not belong to B. How? If x belongs to A, then x does not belong to B, because A intersection B is phi. Means A and B do not have any common elements. A and B are disjoint sets. So if any element belongs to A, then that element does not belong to B because of this reason. Okay, the statement in the question, it is already given that A intersection B is equal to phi. It means A and B are two disjoint sets. Okay, so if x belongs to A, means x does not belong to B. If x does not belong to B, this means x belongs to B complement. Okay, so from here again, if you combine these two terms, these two statements, you will get therefore A is subset of B complement. Okay, now let's come to the B number proof. Take left hand side. If we are getting equal to sign, then we are taking the left hand side. Okay, so left hand side is equal to B intersection A complement. This is equal to x such that x belongs to B intersection A complement. So this will be equal to x such that x belongs to B and x belongs to A complement. Okay, so this will be equal to x such that x belongs to B and x belongs to A complement means x does not belong to A. Is it? Obviously. So this will be equal to x such that x belongs to B and if x does not belong to A, it means x belongs to B. Why x belongs to B? X A ma pardina bhane, x B ma parcha, because A and B are disjoint set from this statement. A and B are disjoint set. So x belongs to B and x belongs to B, it means obviously x such that x belongs to B. So this will be equal to B is equal to right hand side. Okay, so in place of this, we are writing this only because of the given property in the question. Now let's come to our C number proof. Okay, let me erase this question as well. C number proof. C number. Let us take its left hand side. What will you get? That is A union B complement is equal to x such that x belongs to A union B complement. So this will be equal to x such that x belongs to A or x belongs to B complement. Okay, so this is equal to x such that x belongs to A. X belongs to A means x does not belong to A bar or x belongs to B bar. Let us write on same. So this will be equal to x such that x does not belong to A bar means x belongs to B bar. So from here we could write directly this statement. X belongs to A means x belongs to B bar because of the given statement. Or it will be x belongs to B bar. So x belongs to B bar or x belongs to B bar, it means it will be x such that x belongs to B bar. So this is equal to B bar. This is equal to right hand side. Okay, so now my dear friends, with all these concepts, now you can do every question of this type that had appeared in your board exam or that is present in your textbook. So please go through the questions. If you don't know any question, you can ask me anytime in my messenger inbox. Okay, so let us ending this the session today up to here. Tomorrow once again we will be present in this class with starting the concept of logics. Okay, so till then be prepared, stay healthy, stay safe, use masks, wash your hands frequently. Good night, have a sweet dream. Thank you.